back, everybody. So, it's been a little while since we did our last video. Not much has changed in the world. But we still can't do a great deal. So we thought, why not introduce you to the 505's Big Brother? That Big Brother is the 407. But this isn't any 407. This is the latest one. The GXI. And it's good. Really good. So sit back. Let's introduce you to the 407.
The 407 isn't a new aircraft. It was first certified in 1996, and there's over 1,500 or so have been delivered. The first 407 that was brought out was what we call now the analog, which was very similar to the 206. One of our videos of 206 versus 505 pretty covers that. That was called the analog. That was replaced by the GX. One of the differences of the GX to the analog, we went to the Garmin 1000 screens. The next incarnation was the GXP, where the Fram damper from the head was removed because the aircraft is so smooth it just wasn't needed. A little more power came from the engine. We then went to the GXI, which this aircraft is, and this is actually the first GXI to arrive in the UK. Main difference between the GXI and the GXP, we get Garmin 1000 NXI screens, which are the later generation, which are also now fitted standard to the 505. And we also get the dual FADEC on the engine. Historically, the 407 was a single FADEC engine. The GXI is now dual. One of the first things you notice about the 407, it has real presence. It's a great looking aircraft. Second thing you notice, looks very familiar. Clearly it has its lineage from the 206 Long Ranger L4, which the 407 was a direct replacement for. But they are very, very different aircraft. And we're going to walk you through a few of those features now to show you the differences. One of the main differences you notice straight away about the differences between the 407 and the Long Ranger L4 is the rotor system. This is a four-bladed soft in-plane setup as opposed to a two-bladed teetering head setup that we have on the Long Ranger L4. Now this four-bladed system is why you get such a smooth ride in the 407, why it's got such high forward airspeed, and it has great auto-rotative characteristics. The structure of the 407 is very different to that of the Long Ranger L4. There's a lot more composite used in the 407, and there's a lot less rivets, particularly down the side, and the tail boom is completely different. But another thing you notice is here, it's actually blown 4 inches either side, which gives you 8 inches of extra elbow room in the rear, which is a really good feature. You'll notice that on the tail boom, the structure is very different. There's a lot less rivets than there are on the Long Ranger L4, so the whole fuselage is a lot cleaner. There's a lot more composite in the tail boom. You'll also notice that the end plates on the stabilisers are a totally different shape. They're more inverted to what they are on the Long Ranger. 407 retains a two-bladed tail rotor drive system. Difference is they're longer blades, they're wider than they are on the Long Ranger L4. They're also fiberglass and it's a semi-rigid setup. The tail rotor control authority on the 407 is superb. The 407 really is about the rear cabin. This particular 407 has the leather interior, the corporate headliner. It's got air conditioning, so we get the air conditioning in the rear as well as in the front. This one has the slightly wider seats. It is a five-place aircraft, but this one also has the drop-down armrests for greater comfort in the rear. We have a cabin cool system on this particular aircraft, so you can isolate the rear passengers from all the air traffic noise from the pilot or the two crew maybe not wanting to hear what the passengers are saying in the rear. If they do need a pilot's attention, press cabin cool. There's a button that comes up on the instrument panel, which we'll show you later. But this really is a fantastic place to sit. If I pull the door up, and this really emphasises these high-vis windows, this really is as good as flying along with the door off. The visibility from the rear is superb, and the amount of light coming into the cabin is excellent. Makes it a really pleasant environment. If you're a pilot, this is the best place to be in the 407. 407 really is a pilot's machine. It's fast, responsive, very easy to fly, benign. It's just a pleasure, and it has some features on it that we don't get on larger aircraft. Dual fade deck, glass cockpit, and in certain parts of the world this is now cleared for IFR flight, which is incredible. It shows the faith and reliability in the systems and engine that are fitted. If we walk through a few of the systems, we still have our analog gauges as we do in the 505 to get us home should everything fail. We have our two Garmin 1000 NXi screens. These are the latest generation. These are now standard for the 407 and standard for the 505. The NXi is the same screen as the 1000. It's just faster, better resolution. Buttons are laid out slightly differently in a more logical order. If you can use a Garmin 1000, you can use the NXi. A previous video on the Garmin 1000s, if you watch that, it will give you enough information on these screens. Moving down, we have our standard comms pack. This is for changing COM1, COM2, etc., which we can also do as voice command via a button on Cyclic, so we can request COM1, COM2, passengers on. Great feature. But now this comes with Bluetooth. So your passengers, not the pilot, can Bluetooth their phone, make calls if you're allowed to in your country. You can listen to your music wirelessly in the back. One of the greatest features, if you have Garmin Pilot on your tablet, you can flight plan, sitting in your kitchen, come out to the aircraft, load it to the screen, couple it with the autopilot, it will fly that as your pre-described nav. Moving down, we have an autopilot in this aircraft, which is an extra. This is the two-axis. It does come two-axis or three-axis now. The main two features you'll use on this aircraft will be heading and altitude. It has some really good functions which we'll go into when we take you on a virtual demo. So let's have a look at some of the features fitted to this particular 407 GXi that are away from the standard aircraft. First thing you notice is these fantastic windows. So this is the high-vis window package. You'll notice they're actually bowed, which is one feature which gives you more elbow room, which is particularly good in the front. But they're also almost top to bottom. This is as close you'll get to flying with the doors off, but without the drafts, which is excellent. For the rear, what it gives the passengers is a much more open aspect. The daylight coming into the rear cabin is fabulous. It makes it a very pleasant environment. For the pilot, the more visibility you have, the better. But also when you're landing, if you're on a tight helipad, for instance, you can actually see the entire skid. So it actually improves safety as well. But they are a really nice feature. Another feature fitted to this particular 407 is the auxiliary fuel tank, which is located in the luggage compartment. as well as door rams on all doors. This is the auxiliary tank here. It gives you another 25 minutes of fuel. As pilots, we're always looking for a bit more fuel because it makes our day easier and increases our options. It does take a little bit of the boot space up, but we do have a boot extender so you can actually fit that and fill this rear part of the boot as well. This aircraft also has Bose Limo connectors, so it will charge your Bose headsets from the aircraft, so you'll be able to keep putting batteries in. And it also has air conditioning. These are the vents on the side, and also has air conditioning in the rear. Not great on a day like today when it's 5 degrees, but great on the odd day in the UK when we get plus 30. 407 has been sold around the world to do any mission, whether that's corporate, parapublic, air ambulance, long lining. It's a very versatile aircraft and can fit any profile. But that's enough of all this talking about how great it is. Why don't we go flying and show you how good it really is?